We're part of the universe. We're in this universe. The universe is in us. Yes, the universe is within us, said Neil deGrasse Tyson, an American astrophysicist and planetary scientist. All the stars we see in the night sky are made up of atoms, which is what we are made up of. Yes, we're all made up of stardust. I used to look at the night sky and the stars and just wonder about so many things. I used to ask my mom, why is moon following me? That's where my curiosity started towards space. I wanted to touch those stars. And all I knew was that in order to reach them, I needed to fly to the sky. When I was 6 years old, I used to see the airplanes take off and land right from my home terrace in Bangalore, fueling my dream to become a pilot all the more. I'm 26 now, and I'm the co-founder of an NGO that operates for the community, especially students that are interested in space-related pursuits. You might ask, how did I go from dreaming of becoming a pilot to being an entrepreneur in the space sector? I'll let you all know. Being tall was never important to me. Well, at least not until I reached my 12th grade. When reality dawned on me, I literally fell short of being a pilot. It upset me. I gathered myself, what if I can't fly an airplane? I'll learn how to build one. Now I had a new goal and a new path. I decided to pursue aeronautical engineering. I also got an admission to Alliance University for aerospace engineering to study airplanes and spacecrafts. It was like double the markup. Taking lessons about space, determining the orbits, trajectories for satellites, method of controlling them and communicating with them, propulsion system for all our rockets and satellites, designing the aerodynamic shapes, and many more were so intriguing to study. Allow me to recall how my dream of becoming a pilot came true. I co-piloted a short 10-minute flight during my flight lab training at IIT Kanpur. It was a bittersweet to be reminded of the fact that my legs weren't still long enough to reach those foot pedals to control the rudder. Nonetheless, it was a wonderful experience I had. I used to attend all the aerospace-related programs and conferences. During one such conference, I had the privilege of meeting many space enthusiasts like me and professionals from space industry. Among them was Sujay Sridhar, who is currently my partner in professional and personal life. In 2016, Sujay and I formed a community of space enthusiasts and space professionals to create awareness about space and help students with their projects. The community was called the Society for Space Education, Research and Development, in short, SSERD. At SSERD, we came across many students who used to share their concerns like, I thought I would study stars and planets, taking up aerospace engineering. And few mentioned that they thought one would learn how to drive an aeroplane, taking up aeronautical engineering. We were disappointed that many students were not informed about the courses that they were opting in. A dark void between the career of interest and the opted course would often devour them. Few managed to find a way to swim across the shore by redefining their interest in the course. However, a lot of them struggled to get through. It usually would be too late when they realize that it isn't their cup of tea. We found a need to address and made us talk about diversity in space education. We started inviting guest speakers from various space sectors so that students can discuss and understand what are the recent developments and career opportunities that they have. For students who are pursuing their undergraduate programs, we could only help in making better decisions in their course path. It was then we realized the need to tackle this issue at its root. If we are to make a significant change to help them make informed choices, then we are to do so at an early stage. That is how our story of concentrated outreach in schools begin. After all, that's when we all start to dream, right? In 2017, we had our first program, which was Astro Space Camp. When I was a student, I hardly used to find any such NASA space camps here in India. The intention was to create similar camps here in India at affordable price, was what let us start Astro Space Camp. Here, students got a chance to learn from distinguished scientists, take part in stargazing, take a trip to space museum, build rockets, aeroplanes, and much more. After receiving amazing feedback from students and parents, our enthusiasm got boosted up. We started curating courses that would benefit students with a brief introduction to space science and astronomy. Talking about space, I feel it is very important for me to talk what space is and why does it fascinate me so much, you may ask. Well, today, we try to understand the existence of the universe, which fundamentally means we try to understand the very own existence of us. Not only this, when you think about it, multiple research are going on to make our lives better. 250 miles above, on ISS, scientists are working on finding the cure for cancer and other diseases. They study changes in the human body under microgravity so that one day we can plan those long trips to Mars or maybe even further. We try to understand not only Earth, but other planets as well. And surprisingly, stumbling upon planets that are similar to Earth, but finding no life as of yet, is what makes us so exceptionally extraordinary in this cosmic abyss. Now we have sent thousands of satellites into space, of which serve different roles. Communication satellites that allow us to connect with people anywhere in the world. GPS that helps us navigate across the world. When we also have satellites for sustainability. Now, these are just few examples from watching our favorite shows on laptop live, two military defenses, and even the refrigerated food we are consuming. Space has become an inevitable part of our lives. With so much direct impact of space technology on our lives, let me ask you all a question. What do we learn about it in our schools? Today, I'm very dejected to mention that we have only one chapter about space in our science textbooks. And that one chapter will only talk about history. What is in our galaxy? Who was the first person to go to space? Which was the first rocket? Which was the first satellite? Which is exactly what our parents would have studied 30 years ago. Our textbooks are outdated, but there is need for our students to know what is happening in the world today to match the levels of students in other developed countries. Hence, we at SSCRD focus on providing updated information on what is happening at present in space industry of India and the whole world. For students, again, not just in India and rural parts of India, but we started spreading the information among these students in countries like Sri Lanka, Singapore, Philippines, Mauritius, and other African countries where space is never given importance. Putting a technical hat with experience in space education, let me tell you all what briefly space education consists of. Aeronautics and aviation, that speaks about the metal bird that revolutionized the 20th century for traveling. Astronomy that systematically studies the stars and the universe, covering other fascinating topics like exoplanets, mysterious black holes, and wormholes. And then there is space technology, which includes rockets, satellites, missions to land on Moon and Mars, and even asteroids and comets. We also have astronauts to explore microgravity and sustainable life and much more. We at SSCRD are also concentrating on some of the unconventional topics that are never explored or ignored in India, like space medicine, space law, astrobiology, space art, and even entrepreneurship. Our aim is to let students know about all the domains of space so that they can make informed decisions based on their interests. It's better to know the taste before piling it up on the plate. Coming to the second most important problem in space education was method of learning. We all know that in this competitive world, we can't just live with theoretical learning. Practical knowledge is of equal importance. We adopted a special way of learning, that is hands-on and STEM learning. That is learn, build, and launch, or LBL method, which we followed, where equal importance was given to learning the basics of science and theories, build a model to experiment, and then launch and analyze the results, which keeps them in a loop to ideate and rework if something doesn't go according to the plan. Recently launched National Education Policy 2020 has stressed upon such method of learning in STEM education. With all the richest people investing in space sector to go to space, the world now has turned curious than ever to explore space through space tourism. In India, when we say the word space, the first thing that strikes our thoughts is a storm. However, the tide is changing for good. Now we have some promising startups in space industry, such as Skyroot, Agnikul, and Bellatrix, who are building rockets. Companies like Dhruva Space, Pixel are building satellites. Not just that, we have different companies like SatShore, Numerate, and Blue Sky Analytics utilizing satellite data to convert them into downstream products, providing solutions to improve sectors like agriculture and global problems like climate change. These startups will surely grow up to continue the legacy of ISRO in India. Now, all these programs and advancements have inspired students to take up careers in space. However, these students usually lack the necessary guidance on their career path of interest. Through our mentoring sessions, we first understand where the student's interest lies. We then provide with a picture of how they have to move step by step towards achieving their goals. We also provide them with an opportunity to meet and speak to space-related experts. I was thoroughly concerned when I noticed the absence of female students present in our programs. As a woman co-founder, I was determined to fix this problem. I found out that women represent only 35% of all the students enrolled in STEM-related higher education globally. Only 20 to 22% of the workforce in space sector is formed by women. Lack of guidance, financial issues, societal pressure are some of the many reasons I could list. This is when we thought of organizing an event which could be exclusive to females, which female speakers would convene with live examples. Believe it or not, the experiment worked. Soon we had a hall full of young girls and women as part of the event. I still get calls from few girls who attended the program asking for guidance on their work, projects, and even the jobs. The overwhelming response has made us plan one such program every year. And we also started providing scholarships for the female students. I'm eagerly waiting to see all of them achieve their space goals. Well, everything is going well, but Houston, we have a problem. Coming from a middle-class family with an aerospace engineering degree, my parents felt I was wasting my time. They wanted me to get a job that would be lucrative. In addition, I was not just into entrepreneurship, but into social entrepreneurship. Both Sujay and I gave up amazing opportunities and invested our time, money, and effort without expecting money in return. Being first generation entrepreneurs, we faced problems in convincing our families. But students' feedback and the community's support makes us continue to work towards uplifting space education. Space technology has not only helped us understand what is beyond the stars, but also helped us solve many problems here on Earth. With quality space education and guidance, we will be able to tackle many such serious problems. So, are you with me? And thank you.